Hey guys, welcome back, and this is another video. Here what we are doing is we are doing a copy function and we are doing a delete function. So copy function, with what we'll do is we have a certain task that suppose you are downloading in your browser, in your local machine every day, some files from Chrome, from Firefox, from Google, everything, right? So that point of time you will not be having that much of a credibility that okay, what should I do, because your My Documents or download folder will be filled with this type of files. If you are working professional, you will be downloading the CSV files like anything. If you are HR, you will be downloading a resume files like anything. So in that ones, we need to have a simpler Python program which anybody can use. Anybody means anybody. You just need to copy this, you need to just try it out and you will be able to use it. Okay, so what it will do is basically it will select your particular files. Like you want PDF, you want CSV, you want text, you want JPG, you want PNG, you can derive that functionality and then you can use that. So that is for it. And second, the deleting. Suppose you are going on with large downloading of files, like when if you are a database administrator, okay, let it be. I don't want my VPN to work. Sorry for this trouble. Yeah, if you are a database administrator working in a software professional and you have to download server logs are of heavy toll to your system, right? So that time of point of time you will decide a limit that my server logs daily are of 43 MB or of 100 MB, and I'll do the same, I'll delete those files. But yeah, before deleting, you can copy that and then delete that particular folder. You can move particular file if you don't want to, but today we will not be doing the move function, we will be doing the copy and delete. So copy first we will go through. As I told you, we will be just, if you see here, we will be just putting out the PDF one and the JPG one, right? I mean the text file as well as the text file as well as the JPG file. So let's go ahead, let's see this function. We will be just calling the function onto a folder, and the folder will be getting the absolute path for this, and then we will be just we'll be just passing it. Okay, we'll be passing it through a new folder, we will be creating a custom. So if you see it here, I will show you somewhere, it will be there, maybe here. Okay, so let me just show you where I put this custom folder. So if you see, my programs is there, and then it will create a my programs underscore custom folder. And if the path is not there, then make that path. Okay, if the path is not present, if the directory is not present, we'll make the path. And for folder name, subfolders, file name, the OS walk function will do is, if by now you have not identified, it will go through each and everything. If there is a folder inside a folder and folder inside a folder, this particular piece of library and the function will take that into consideration. So you don't have to worry about it. So now if you see, for now we will just assume that there is a folder, okay, and then there is a file. So how we will go? We will go like this. We will go inside a file name and we will be getting the custom folder path. So we will be getting the folder name, we will be getting it here, like the first 01 before the split. And then we will see if the custom folder is equal to new folder. That means if this folder and this folder are same, then continue. Otherwise, we have to do something there. I mean, it will be there. Otherwise, what will happen is it will, if this folder is not same, it will go inside that target folder also. And sometimes what will happen, you will see the same file there and same file here. You will just copying the same thing. So it will be basically overwrite and it will not be able to find the file. If you are able to understand, you are copying the same file into the same directory, and Python you have to do basically an exception for it. So we don't have any kind of requirement right now. We are already checking if the folder name is there or not. Then extension, we will be getting the extension for the path of the file name, and we will see if the length of extension is greater than 0, if you know that. And here we will be using the split text functionality. What does split text will do? You are giving him, right? It will give you the split text, I mean the slash one, and it will give you that particular link or particular path. Here what we are doing is we are also splitting the, and if I will just print it for you, I think it's better I print all those things for you. Yeah, let us print and we'll show you the log. Okay, so here we will be splitting the PDF. It will be like this dot PDF dot something. So what it will do is it will give you the only file which has an extension. Otherwise, some file which will not have extension will cause this program to error out. And then we will be using the shuttle.copy method. We will be giving the target source file name and the target folder. Okay, and then we'll be adding. So we don't need to use this copy function here. So let's just use the selective copy first. And yeah, so if you see this particular right, it will be here right now in the visible section. If you see here, this particular program, what we did here, we basically created a zip file. So let me just clear it out. And let me just run selective copy. And we get an error here. Why? Because here in the extension, if you see, it will be giving us somewhere the problem that you have a problem in the file, and this is the file name dot split and all those things, because you have to basically split the extension, which is we are not doing here. So let me just comment it out and I'll let you know by the end of this video. So yeah, if you see like this now, let me just copy this so that you also know what we are going to do here. Okay, I'm copying this here. So if you see, first it went inside this, it found out this one, there is nothing to find it out. It went inside this, it hasn't found anything because it's a zip file. It went inside this, it found something, JPG nothing, PDF it found one. Then it went inside this, it found nothing, it found one PDF here in the custom, again it went inside this. Okay, so it is adding files wherever it is find the PDF, right? It is adding the file to my program custom. That's how it is done. So let me just give you a brief overview. If you see it here, it has created a file, my program custom, and it has copied all the JPG and PDF files. So that is as simple as it can be. And yeah, that is how we have to do. If you are able to understand, see, the split text, right, it will split it, so it will be a tuple. And if you are in the tuple, if you are using a function split, that means it should not be done, it should be inside a string only. So if you want to figure it out, I'll just keep it on to you. It's a very simple debugger because you will be using that. And please use the print method anywhere you want. It will give you a hell lot of information than any other program, that what the program is doing, kind of a debugging, right? And now let's go to the delete. Delete is very much easier. We are not deleting the files right now because those are files which are very dear to me. Those are my recordings of the videos, those are my audio recordings. I don't want to delete that. So this function we will be is a very slightly small function. And here I have told you in the previous program the extension path in the os.split text path, right, custom folder path, you can also use that. But here we are just imagining that we have a folder and we have the files inside it. So we will be just going inside the folders and we will be getting the full path, like how we are getting it here, folder name slash slash file name. We will be seeing if the file is greater than 100 MB. If the file is greater than 100 MB, we will be using this function. If you want to delete, there is a simple command for deleting the files, you can use that. And we are using my own sound recordings one. And yeah, just let the run the program. It's very simple, right? So yeah, this is how it is. It will go, it will check all this one. If I can maximize this, I cannot maximize this. So yeah, so if you see it here, it will just show you all the programs which are greater than 100 MB. So that's how we can do. It's very simple. What thing we are doing is we are doing the get size function. Here what we are doing the main way is the split text one and a shuttle dot copy. This is how it's very simple. We will be back with another video, pretty short, pretty quick, and I want to finish this all this part very soon. And please like, share, subscribe, because that is the most important part right now. And even if you don't, if you have watched this video till now, it's enough for me, because as it at the end, this is a instructional video and this is a informational video. If it reaches to many people, if it helped you in some point of time, 10 years down the time it is helping you, give a thumbs up and let's see. All the best.